Nebuchadnezzar. And the Bible says they gave the message to Nebuchadnezzar. They say they don't want to worship this gold, this image we got set up. Nebuchadnezzar was he felt it fury. The Bible says he heated up the furnace. I come out here to tell you, come on somebody, you may have faith, but every now and then your faith will have a fire inside. Oh, heaven, oh, go. Every now and then you have to get in the fire. Every now and then you're going to get sick a little bit. Every now and then you're going to feel depressed a little bit. Yeah, you may have a spirit on the inside, but every now and then the flesh get a little weak. Every now and then the knees stop bothering you. Every now and then the foot stop bothering you. But while you got a bad foot, all you got to do it like this right here. Tell them, get back. The fire stop. Then the Hebrew boys, they say, okay, you done heated it up. They done heated it up. The Bible says seven times hotter. This thing is getting serious. You thought just because your husband got hit in a car accident, this thing done heated it up seven times hotter. Now your son done got busted for drugs. Satan done heated up seven times hotter. Now your daughter got caught doing prostitution act. Now she want to sit down like she wasn't involved. Now the flame is heating up seven times hotter. They right in the front of the test. See, a lot of times people want the results of the test, but they don't want to take the test. See, everybody want to go to heaven, but nobody really want to die. Oh, come on, somebody. The Bible says we got to present our bodies as a living sacrifice. I'm glad you asked. You may not felt like coming to church. You may not felt like putting on clothes. You may felt laying down. But when you present your body, as Romans 12 say, as a living sacrifice, you'll say, in spite of how I feel, in spite of what's going on, I may look at my purse and all I got is $5 in a pack of chewing gum, but I'm still coming to church. I may not got about $8 my wallet, but I'm still coming to church. My son may be acting and crazy. Next school told me he got ADHD. Say the Lord rebuke you. See, the enemy in this new society, he's trying to plant a seed into the children. The Bible says a lot of times the children of darkness will be wiser than the children of light. So now they say, oh, your kids is dyslexic and he's hypertension and he's this, that, and the yonder. And all we got to do is get a little Ritalin and medicine and give him shots and Prozac and this, that, and the yonder. But I stop right here to tell you, the boy, he may be chemically dependent on your shape. But my Bible says that's a spirit. That from? I'm glad you asked. Because the Bible said in the book of Matthew chapter 17, that there was a lunatic son that brought his child forth to Jesus. So we know what a lunatic is. Somebody half crazy. Because the Bible said often he will fall in the fire, then he'll fall back in the feather. And I come by here to tell you, when you're in cap with a lunatic spirit, you will almost flip out of somebody out. But when you're born again, saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost, you was going to cuss the sister out, but all you got to do is say, girl, God bless you. You're going to really tell them how you really felt, but then you'll swallow it because the Holy Spirit is working on the inside. So the things that you was going to say, now you're pulling back the rain that's coming when you to say. You know how it was. When you got in trouble, see, I was raised in Marietta, Florida. Yes, I was raised in Marietta, Florida. Home of all the prisons and this, that, and the others. But we still got clay hills up there. And you didn't talk when grandma was talking. You better ask for nothing. If you were bleeding, you better hope grandma hurry up with her conversation to ask for the band-aid. Yes. It wasn't no time out. It you ain't get a warning. The first time, she'll look at you. She'll be talking and cooking. She's like, oh, Mary. She's like, oh, Judy, come on in. Come on, let me talk to you. She ain't gonna talk to you. What you doing? Yes, it wasn't no child protective services. You can call them HRS if you can get to the phone. But here it is. The Hebrew boys been right in front of that test. But they refused to look back. They refused to give in and throw in the towel. They refused to disorder and go over the test. The Bible say, they said, and he said, we'll heat it up 7 times hotter. So I come by here to tell you, if you want to be purified, you got to be willing to go through the fiery furnace. You got to be willing to go through some flame. But the Bible said when they got in the furnace. See, sometimes we look for deliverance after the furnace. But I come by here to tell you, you can get delivered while you in the fire. You can get, come on somebody, you can get delivered while you in the sick bed. You can get delivered while you're broken down and out and down the food stamps. You ain't got number $8 left on the green card. You ain't got number $9 left on the EBT card. But the trust in God. But the Bible says, while they was in the furnace, the king noticed something. He noticed something. He said, there's another one in there. Looked like the son of man. He received the revelation. And the Bible said they were, not only they was in the fire, but they were walking around in the fire. See, some folk don't, he just gave me a revelation. Some folk don't want you to function while you're in the fire. They want you to be down and out and depressed and you going through this and you going through that. And they want you to sit back and be all sobbing. Child, I don't know how I'm going to make it. And you know I'm just going to keep trusting the Lord. You only got no kind of enthusiasm about it. And your faith seems like it's freeze dried. And seems like you got the faith in the freezer all the way in the back with a water bottles. Come on, somebody. You better learn how to get your faith out of cold case files and come out of witness protection. Some of us scared to even talk to about God. We can talk about everything else. We can talk about the new TV show Power. Well, Omar, you know him, the same brother that played the Four Color Girls. He getting all the roles now. He clean cut, you know it. Don't act like you don't know. You know. We talk about Atlanta Housewives. We was talk about the Miami Heat game, but when they lost, you couldn't even find nobody on Facebook saying nothing. But when they were winning, they were talking about LeBron this, Dwayne Wade this, and this, that, and the other. But all of a sudden, when they lost the last 3 games, it seemed like all the Miami Heat fans went back to Miami. And living right here, sir. Don't feel bad, Pastor. My so-called team lost too. I would act like I was rooting for the Brooklyn Nets, but I was sure, man. But they lost. I played it all real good, actually. But I played that thing real good. I act like I wasn't worried about it. Man, I was worried about all bad. I was so happy LeBron James lost, I ain't know what to do. When they lost 3 games by 20 points a piece, I began to shout. Watch this. I got 4 points. 4 points. It don't slide on your way. But the rewards of faith. A lot of times people that were regarded for having great faith weren't church savvy. Preacher, where you getting that from? I'm getting it from Matthew chapter 8. The Bible says it was a centurion soldier. He said, you are a man of authority. I'm a man of authority. I got a servant that's home sick. All you got to do is speak the word. And here, this man with no Bible told him. He ain't going to no type of theological school. He want part of Holy Ghost Headwaters, 5 baptized, Baptist church, and little house, this, that, and the other, Baptist church, and this is don't know who the real McCoy is. Oh, preacher, where you getting that from? I think I'm getting that from Acts chapter 19. The Bible says the sons of Sephanah, they didn't come to choose a priest. And the Bible said these men were demon possessed. And they began to talk to these priests, and they began to give out a resume. See, you know the devil will give you a resume about who he know. So you better make sure you're strapped and equipped. I ain't talking with a 38 special. I ain't talking with a 44 Magnum. But you better make sure you got the love of Christ on the inside of your heart. You better learn how to get some scriptures on the inside. Because Psalms 119 says that by the scriptures we are saved. Yes. It's through the scriptures we are able to pierce those fiery darts. And that's what David said, I hid the word in the heart, Psalms 119:11, that I might not sin against thee. Then Solomon followed that up in Proverbs 4:23. He said, guard the heart with all due diligence. In other words, be careful what you allow to come into your spirit, man. See, a lot of folk, we're inviting them into our spiritual sanctuaries. Now, we ain't talking about temple of life of a worship center. No, we're talking about our individual. See, we are the church. Let me help somebody. We are the church. This right here don't have no soul, no spirit, no nothing. This is just a place where we come to worship. But we are the church. So sometimes folks say they're leaving the church, I look at them kind of funny. You leaving the what? You must mean you leaving a dwelling. Because you're supposed to be the church. Come on, somebody. Peter said, upon this rock, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Yes. David said in Psalms 41:11, he said, by this thou know that thou art with me, because my enemies do not triumph over me. In other words, they may come at me, they may fight against me, but they don't pose them be winning the battle. And that's where we got to go back to. Where is our faith? But here these Hebrew boys standing in front of this furnace. Now they in the furnace, and the fire wouldn't burn them. Now they're coming out of the furnace. I come out here to tell you, they didn't even preach a sermon. Somebody said your life should be, come on somebody, a book. Somebody may not ever get the chance to read the Bible, but your life should mimic the word. Because if you say Christ is love and Christ in you, we love. The Bible said when they came out of the furnace, the king stood up and he looked and he said at the latter part of that verse, he said, because they trusted their God. See, sometimes folk, when things get a little tough, we go back to some of the old ways and some of the old habits that we done put in the freezer. But every now and then, why ain't no members looking, we'll pull them out of the freezer. We know pastor ain't looking, we'll pull it out of the freezer. We thinking so-and-so live on the other side of town, so we'll begin to pull it out of the freezer. We'll find ourselves back at the weed man. Oh, my Lord. Then they say, oh, weed ain't a drug. Well, most people I used to know smoke, they ain't care nothing about their bills. And I said, man, I don't want none of that. I understand y'all getting high, y'all feeling good, but I like the AC, so I'm going to pay my light bill. Y'all can say what you want to say. I like cable, I'm paying them, I don't care how I'm going to pay them, I'm going to pay them. But see, a lot of times, when the heat is on, and a lot of times when the heat is on, a lot of people want to run from the test. But David withstood the test. Because 1 Samuel chapter 17, as he encountered Goliath, David said, hold on, Saul. See, I'm not used to fighting with all this stuff. I haven't proven these things. You use what you use. But I'm going to use what I got. I may ain't got nothing but a